Good morning, students of class 9. Welcome back to the online classes now. Let's do our geography lesson, physical feature of India. So far we have learnt about the Himalayas, the northern plains, plateau regions. Now we'll go to the desert region, the Indian desert. We'll talk about the Indian desert, which lies in Rajasthan and part of Gujarat. So now here, Indian desert is also known as Thar desert. So you must have heard the name before, Thar desert or the Indian desert. There are 7 points I've written over here. The Indian desert lies towards the western side of Aravalli Hills. Aravalli Hills, beyond Aravalli Hills, towards the western side, from there the desert of Rajasthan starts. It is an undulating. Undulating means uneven, not straight, not flat. Undulating means uneven. It is an undulating sandy plain. You will see sand and sand everywhere. Very dry region. The area is covered with sand dunes. Dunes means heaps, a heap of sand. Very high heaps, that's called sand dunes. It is because of the wind. When the wind blows very strongly, strong wind blows the sand from this area to that area. Because it is heavier, it cannot be blown far away. From this area to that area, from there again, that means the sand dunes keep on moving because of the wind. So now we'll talk about the region. This region, the desert region, this region receives very, very little rainfall, below 75 centimeters. So very little, scanty rainfall. That's why there are no vegetation. The area is so dry, the fine particle of the mud or the soil is blown away. Only the heavier particle, coarse particle, the rough particle, sand particles are left behind. And that too, sometimes it is blown away, but not very far away, and stacks there, becomes a heap. That's called sand dunes. It has dry climate. The region has got a very dry climate with low vegetation cover. Practically there are no vegetation, only thorny shrubs and some date trees are found over. That too where a little bit of water is found, where there is a little moisture in the soil, only there you will find some vegetation. Otherwise it is barren, you can say, without any vegetation. Very little vegetation cover. Number 5, streams. The streams that originate in rainy areas. In rainy areas, the stream originates, starts and flows towards the desert region. But while it flows, the water seeps inside the ground. Streams that originate in rainy areas flow in this region, but soon they disappeared on the way due to sand. On the way, while flowing, they disappeared in the sand. Because it is sandy, the water does not flow on the sand. It seeps inside, it percolates inside. As they do not have enough water, some of the streams, they do not have sufficient water and it will not reach far away places. On the way, it dries up. Luni, river Luni is the only large river over here. That too, it receives rain water from the rainfall areas and it flows inside desert region and falls into Sambar Lake. There is a lake that is famous, Sambar Lake. From there, we get salt. The Luni River falls into Sambar Lake. Luni River doesn't enter the sea. It enters the lake. That's called Sambar Lake. The water, Luni River receives water in the rainy areas, certain rainy areas of western side. and they receive rainfall, and while flowing a little larger river, while flowing they enter Sambar. Now here, Luni is the only large river here. Barchins, here is a drawing of Barchin, a crescent shaped, C shaped, capital C shape, sand dunes. It is because of the wind. The wind blows the sand from here and starts depositing over here. And starts over. And it becomes a heap. And once the wind again touches this portion, it starts blowing and starts collecting over here. The dune. That is called barchins. Crescent shaped dunes. It is due to the wind. Barchins, crescent shaped dunes cover large areas. The desert is full of barchins, yani ki sand dunes. You can see them from Jaisalmer. If you go and visit Jaisalmer, from Jaisalmer you can see the barchins, the sand dunes, because from the Jaisalmer westward the desert starts, and it is more prominent near the Indo-Pakistan border. Near India-Pakistan border you will find more barchins, higher barchins, tall. So they were high. So this is for Thar desert, the Indian desert. Now in our next class we'll talk about the coastal plain or coastal region, the coastal plain. That's also one of the physical feature of our country. Then after that we'll talk about the island groups, Andaman Nicobar Island and Lakshadweep Islands. We'll talk about that. Two more physical features are left. So coastal plains we'll talk about in our next class. The Thar desert we have this much only. So that's all for today. Thank you for watching the video. Stay safe. You go through the online portal every day so that you will not miss anything. If you do not understand, it will be difficult for you later on. So you must go through the online portal. It will not take very long time. So make a habit of that. So that's all for today. We'll meet in the next class. Thank you for watching.